Take a moment to reflect upon what it is that allows you to experience the world around you, the one that has brought us all here today to share information and disseminate new ideas. Our shared histories would tell us that our identities and our positions within the world rely on us existing in the same reality. This shared social world allows us to feel, think, and engage with one another in a deep and meaningful way. But what if your experience of reality frequently departed from this shared social world, and you began to exist in a different reality, characterized by confusing, frightening, and isolating experiences? This is just a glimpse of what daily life can be like for people living with schizophrenia, which is a severe and complex mental illness. Current treatment options are severely limited, with our best medications only improving symptoms of psychosis, like hallucinations and delusions, but not other really disabling symptoms, like impairments in cognition, social interaction, and verbal and emotional expression. These medications also don't work in one third of all patients and can have really serious, life-threatening side effects. And so identifying new treatments for schizophrenia really is imperative. This is exactly what my PhD work aims to do. I'm using an experimental model of impaired brain development as well as living immune cells from the brain called microglia to investigate whether a drug called raloxifene could be used to treat schizophrenia. Research has shown that raloxifene improves psychosis and aspects of cognition in both men and women with schizophrenia, but we don't know how raloxifene is doing this. Understanding the processes and mechanisms in the brain that raloxifene is altering to then modify symptoms of schizophrenia is key to understanding who raloxifene might work for and at what point during the course of their illness this drug could be most effective. This might also give us an idea about other novel drug therapies that might be even more effective at targeting those processes in the brain that raloxifene is altering. My current experimental work suggests that raloxifene is altering some behaviours relevant to schizophrenia in both male and female rodents. And we think raloxifene is doing this by altering a key neurotransmitter or neurochemical messenger in the brain called dopamine. And this molecule is widely disrupted in the brains of people with schizophrenia. We also have evidence to show that raloxifene is altering the function of those immune cells called microglia. And the next critical step in my research is to use live cell imaging technology to assess just how raloxifene is altering the function of those immune cells. I have family members affected by schizophrenia, and so I know firsthand how devastating it can be for them and their loved ones. But I'm confident that my research will provide fundamental knowledge required to discover new treatments to help people with schizophrenia rejoin our shared social world so that they can interact with us all in a more meaningful way. Thank you.